Like before, I did do a little peek at the next quest. And I'm gonna do something a little different because I'm not sure. I'm hoping I'm not making the wrong call here. I'm gonna go ahead and get this not swift travel ride because I don't really want to do the riding myself. But I also don't want it to go by too fast. Because I think that this quest, or we're bringing the Sigil of Drugoth that we got at Heligrod to Master Elrond. And I feel like based on what the next quest after this one is, it's pretty much just that. We're just bringing the Sigil and we're going to turn it into him. The quest, I mean. So I wanted to not have it be like just a few sad minutes, you know? We could make a little pit stop in the Hall of Fire and do a tiny little bit of crafting. That's not something I don't think I've ever done in a YouTube video for Lotro. I do that a lot when I'm streaming just to quickly level or occupy some time. I did a lot of crafting on the Baggin's birthday, for example, because the Baggin's birthday took about 10 minutes and I did a whole stream for it. It seems crazy. It feels like forever ago that I first came to Rivendell on this character, but it also feels like it just happened in a way. I don't remember if it was before August or in August. Could have been in August. I think it was, because I think that's when I caught up to... Yeah, because I think I remember doing book 3. Like all in one stream. But I don't know if that was August or not. Now I'm confusing myself. I've played so much Lotro in the last 2 months. And I'm gonna play a lot more until I get to level 50. This is one of those times where I'm like starting to kind of stream of consciousness my thoughts. At a really weird moment in my pre-recording. But since this is a little bit closer to the end of the month, I'm thinking tentatively that once I reach level 50 on Lotro, I do have a bunch of alts though that I might just play on as well and reach level 50 on. But I'm tentatively thinking of going through my schedule throughout spooky season and also getting other MMO characters to level 50 or doing a really big chunk of playing a certain game for a while to kind of make up for not really having the rotation so much anymore. I do still need to... So I bought... This is so completely off topic to Lotro at all, but I bought Star Wars Outlaws and I did a pre-order to get the early access. And then immediately found out when I tried to play the game the first time on stream that my computer's specs were not even... I don't think they... There was just one that was incompatible with the game. And it was my RAM. So I bought some RAM sticks to do an upgrade. Because I can see, and I have a transparent side to my PC, to the tower, and I can see where the RAM sticks go, and I can see the one that's in there, and I got a lot of advice about the ones that I bought, but I have been procrastinating doing the upgrade, and I think I just need to buckle down and do it, but I'm a little bit worried about, like, messing it up, especially right ahead of spooky season. So I might put it off until November again, but I feel like I'm missing out so much on, like, Outlaws content, and I really, really want to add it into my rotation, especially because I added Growing Up into my schedule, and I did that just to accommodate adding Outlaws, but I do really like Growing Up, so I will continue and do more little mini-series of that. Oh, I'm here at Elrond. I forgot I was going to the Hall of Fire. Just, we'll pretend we didn't see him. This is like a filler episode. Yeah, but I might keep putting the RAM upgrade off a little longer. But I'm going to do it eventually, because I bought the RAM sticks. And I think it'll help with other things, too. I've been going back and forth here in the last Homely House a lot the last few days, and I've gotten a little bit used to just jumping off of that third terrace floor. And if you do it just right, there's like a spot, I think, is that, yeah, so there's a spot, I think the third floor is like right here. You can land on this, the little archways on the stairwell, and then you can hop down from there and you won't break your leg. Just a little tip. I don't really have much. I kind of wish I hadn't made all that black barley flour so that I could have made some more oatmeal, but it's fine. I'm gonna go to the end of the hall. Oh, I don't even need to be in here to do this. I don't need to be in here to do this because you don't need oh, and I don't have any honey anyway, so this is just all pointless because I'm just gonna walk back to Elrond now. But it's kind of nice to get my thoughts out after a while, like when I have plans. I think, tentatively also, my plan for spooky season is to still do my rotation, but it's going to be a very Latro-heavy rotation. So, we'll see how the schedule works out. But I miss my other games and series and stuff. It just occurred to me that I still have, like, this is, right now it's September 26th, and this won't be up until, I think, September 29th. So what if I had just done the RAM upgrade in between? What if it was already done by the time this went up?
All right, let's see about this.
Dark days.
Yeah, I was right. You just turn it in and then it's done. But I got my thoughts out and that was a good thing. I shared a tip about jumping in the last homely house. I think that was a good thing. I've got one more chapter to go. That'll be up tomorrow. So until then, thank you for watching and have a great day.